Hello, my name is Kamila Kokotka-Nikuła. With me is Kinga Zając. We are members of the European Network of Open Education Librarians. And here we want to present to you the UNESCO recommendation on open educational resource.
First of all, the document in question is concerned with OER, which stands for Open Educational Resources. Quoting the recommendation, those are learning, teaching and research materials in any format and medium that reside in the public domain or are under copyright that have been released under an open license that permit no-cost access, reuse, repurpose, adaptation and redistribution by others. UNESCO first developed this definition in 2002, and since then, the idea of open materials for education gathers more and more attention. Countries and organizations are working on initiatives to support the OER idea, their creation and propagation. However, those initiatives are decentralized and in need of a framework to ensure the unification of policies and actions. And here comes the UNESCO recommendation on open educational resources from 24th of November 2019, adopted unanimously by the UNESCO General Conference.
The document acknowledges earlier initiatives in the field of education and learning, the importance of information and communications technology, and the role of information and knowledge in society. It aims to support and advance the Ljubljana OER Action Plan, adopted during the Second World Open Educational Resources Congress in 2017. The UNESCO OER recommendation recognizes five crucial areas of action. We will dive into explaining those five areas in our future recordings. For now, the areas are building capacity of stakeholders to create, access, reuse, adapt and redistribute OER, developing supportive policy, encouraging effective, inclusive and equitable access to quality OER, nurturing the creation of sustainability models for OER, and the last, promoting and reinforcing international cooperation.
UNESCO urges member states to present the OER recommendation to those who are responsible for learning, education and research, and take all the steps needed to make OER an essential and actively worked on issue. That cannot be achieved without consulting the stakeholders, who, in this case, are people connected with education and learning, cultural institutions, researchers, civil society organizations, publishers and copyright holders, and authors, to name a few. The list of the stakeholders is long, which makes sense since OER can and should be a significant part of the lives of many citizens and societies as a whole. And here you have it, the first glance at UNESCO recommendation on open educational resources. Take a look at the document yourself if you have a moment, and soon we will start to go deeper into the specific areas of action. Thank you for listening!